I want to welcome legendary Ronnie Hudson to Local Camp Viral Interviews. Thank you very much for joining us today, Mr. Hudson.
Thank you for having me on your show.
Appreciate it so much for you coming out. I wanted to get right to it, talk to you about that West Coast classic, West Coast pop lock. I mean, I grew up listening to the song, and I still hear them bumping it at parties. And did you know that this song was going to have that kind of an impact?
When I wrote that song, honestly, I did not know that it would have that sort of impact, nor did I think that it would touch every portion of the West Coast. And that's what was so unusual. It lingered and just hovered over the whole entire West Coast, and that was amazing to me, and that was something that I did not expect.
And what kind of research did you do before you wrote that song? I've seen in the past that you talked about you did your research before you wrote that song.
Yeah, I have my manager, Michael Hooks, decided that he wanted me to write a song, so he brought me a title over, and the title was the West Coast Pop Lock. And he asked me if I could write the lyrics to it, and I assured him that I could, of course. And he says, okay, let me see what you can do. So a few days later, I was to have the song ready.
Right.
But I didn't know enough about what he wanted me to find out. He wanted me to talk about Compton and Watts and Los Angeles in the song. And so the only way for me to find out what was going on is to go and research, go to these places and meet people and find out how they live and what goes on. And I did that. I went to Watts, and I got there. I spoke with the gangsters. They were like, man, well, nobody shows us love over here. And I showed them. I said, well, you know, that's why I'm here. I'm here to show you love.
That's what's up.
Forever. The way that I'm going to do this, it'll be love forever. And he said, well, how can you do that? I said, well, if I were to put it in a song, and I think that would do it forever. What you think? And they were really, really fascinated by that. And I also went to Compton and received this pretty much the same as I did in Watts. It was really good. I was welcomed, and I told my story of what I planned to do. And then I followed through with it.
Right.
And once I did that, I heard from Compton, Watts, and everybody. I mean, they were like, hey, man, thank you for the love. And I hear it even for today. I think I'll hear it forever, you know?
Right. Feel about the Mexicans, how the Mexican community was grasping onto that song for so long and never let it die. Like, it's a big impact how Mexicans just never let it go. How do you feel about that, how it had an impact on the Mexican community?
I had so many supporters. The Mexicans was a huge support team for Ronnie Hudson. I was supported by the Latinos, by so many people. It was incredible. I wish you could see it from where I stand. It was really amazing. And they kept the song in rotation for so, so many years. I feel as though that I want to do something for the Mexican community, for the Latinos, for the people who supported Ronnie Hudson for all of those years. Due to their support, the song was just doing everything, commercials and all sorts of stuff. We give someone else an idea, then the movie industries picked up on it. I think it's been in like 22 movies.
22 right movies that song has been featured on?
Yeah,
that's got to be a record, man.
Yeah, I think so. And if I'm not mistaken, it's going to be in something next year, another movie. But it's incredible. And but due to the Latino community, the song was, I think that's what really made it. It had the lyrics to become the anthem, but the push that it got from the Latino community was incredible. And I feel like I owe them something. And I'm going to do something in some way to give something back to the community. Maybe I'll think in terms of doing a free concert or something like that. And I'll figure out where to do that.
You know, let me know. I'll help you get that word out.
If you would like to be involved in that, that would be... we have a few other people to help support that.
I appreciate that. I wanted to talk also about a couple of other tracks that you have, some classics that people might not know about. Like, I want to talk about like California Love, how big that song was. Can you tell me a little bit about how that song got in Tupac's hands? Was it Dre? Was it the label? How did that come about? If you could tell us a little bit about that, people that don't know.
Yes, I can. Back in the day, you didn't hear much of people using other people's tracks. But I was one of those that decided to use the Zap Band track, So Rough, So Tough, and redo it and put my lyrics to it. That wasn't something that was common during those days. But I think I may have been one of the ones to help make that common.
You've been a pioneer, man. A lot of different things. You've been leading the way. Sorry for interrupting you, but, man, I just had to throw it in there, man.
I appreciate it. And, we helped to get the hip-hop and this sort of thing on the move and get it going. West Coast Pop Lock is classified as hip-hop. And also as the West Coast National Anthem. Or the West Coast Anthem, I should say. And I'm very proud of that. And as I mentioned, I would love to do something for the Spanish community to show my appreciation for making this song what it is today. And I've received so many awards, I just recently received an award and expecting maybe another, perhaps.
Another Grammy?
Yes, I recently received a Grammy, and I'm nominated for another Grammy right now, and I just found that out.
What a surprise,
I don't even
man.
Know what for, but at this time, but...
Man, you're getting Grammys, you don't even know what for, huh?
How about that, man?
You're like, what?
And of course, I've received the multi-platinum for West Coast Pop Lock, California Love. Tupac helped to make the song. He really put it there on the map. Then he explained that was one of the biggest hits he's ever had. So that was something that... that came by way of Dr. Dre and that crew over there, which I appreciate today. And I'm going to catch up with Dre and have a little fun with him.
That's what's up. I know you recently dropped an album. What's it called, and what kind of artists do you have on there?
Well, I have a new CD. It's called West Coast, without the G on the end. You're like, all right, by Ronnie Hudson. This album is a very positive album. We have cuts on it like Don't Throw Your Life Away, Gangster R.I.P., Hijack at the Players Club. You know, it's an album that's talking to people, and we're trying to get some of our youth people to go in the right And in doing that, we figured like the best people to get to do that would need to be somebody who people would listen to.
Right.
So in that regard, we talked about Snoop Dogg, and when Snoop came aboard, he's on the CD with us. And then we have Wyclef Jean. He came aboard. He's on the CD with us. We have E-40, Too Short. We have Rapid Forte, Sugar Free.
Man, you got an all-star lineup.
Yeah, man. And Battlecat is on there. I mean,
and what's that one single you got out right now? You have a single right now out, don't you, with all those guys? And Sally Sal, what's it called, that one single?
Yeah, Sally Sal. Yeah, he's on there with us. And the crew is on that one, my brother.
Nice.
You got the crew on there, baby.
That's what's up.
Yeah, that's what's up.
So where can the fans follow you or purchase your music?
You can find my music on the iTunes, all of the you can find it on iTunes, you can find it on you can find it anywhere on the internet.
There it is.
It's out there, and you can find it in
iTunes, all digital stores.
Most places that sell CDs on Viva, some of the Walmarts and Targets, some of those places I believe there, you can find them there.
It's not too hard to find Ronnie Hudson at your local stores, Walmart, all digital stores. Do you have a website?
I do. I have a website. It's called RonnieHudson.com.
There it is.
You can go there, and I can be reached by email on that site. And also, there is a phone number on that site, RonnieHudson.com.
Even the number. What else you guys want? Mr. Ronnie Hudson, keep me posted on the event, and I'll help out, push, and do my part, do everything I can to help put the word out. And again, I really appreciate you coming out here and talking to me, and letting people know, update us, and dropping that knowledge so those that don't remember, they know what time it is now.
Sure. I'm going to leave this with you, too. After this CD, I'm going to drop a single, and you'll be one of the first to hear this. It's gonna be called Lowrider.
Oh, there it is.
Yeah, it's coming, baby.
Man, you need to let me get a verse in there.
Okay, well,
all right, man. All right, Ronnie. I appreciate you again, man. Thank you very much.